Remembrance Day obviously marked right around the nation, including in Melbourne. Andrea Crothers is there at the Shrine of Remembrance, the Prime Minister and the Premier there too, Andrea.
Kieran, they were among the 1,000 people who gathered here at the Shrine of Remembrance in Melbourne. The opportunity to gather in person after a tumultuous couple of years certainly not lost on those who gathered here to pay their respects to those who made the ultimate sacrifice. Now, here in Melbourne, the service particularly focused on the first 21 years of the 21st century, reflecting not only on those who've served abroad in that time, but also those who've done their efforts back at home, particularly during the fires, floods and bushfires. Today there was also the releasing of 100 pigeons. It was a bit of a nod to the 20,000 pigeons which were released back when the shrine was opened in 1934.
At the heart of our remembrance today lies the gratitude of a nation. We're grateful for our safety, for the peace made and the peace kept in places near and places far. And we're grateful for the support that our communities received here at home, whenever and wherever we found ourselves most tested. These are the reasons why we pause to remember, and these are the reasons why we must not forget.
The Prime Minister was among the dignitaries here today, laying a wreath alongside Victoria's Premier. Scott Morrison earlier also attended a veterans breakfast where he really spoke about Australians need to owe a lot to returned servicemen and women, and also said there's a lot more for the government left to do.
To the veterans in this room, I want you to know we are a government that seeks to listen. Not all the things are easy to hear, and they're not all easy to tell. But I want you to know that those ears will always be attentive to the stories that you wish to share with us and the lessons that you know we need to learn.
Now, today also holds special meaning for the family of a Victorian soldier killed in battle more than a century ago. Lieutenant James Kennedy's final resting place at last located, his body identified in what was once an unnamed grave in France, Kieran.